If you're not using AI to automate your business, you're falling behind. Let's fix that. Did you know you could replace your receptionist for a few dollars every month? No lunch break, works weekends and nights, and never quits on you. And you can speak any language you need. Businesses lose thousands of dollars every year because they miss calls or don't have anyone available to book appointments 24/7. In this video, I'm going to show you how to build an AI-powered receptionist in just 15 minutes. It can answer questions, schedule appointments, and grow your business while you sleep. I'll show you step by step how to set up a fully automated virtual assistant for a dental office or any business using ElevenLabs for voice AI and Cal.com for appointment setting. For those new to the channel, I'm Remi Taffin, a software engineer and AI automation expert. On this channel, I show you how to automate your business, save time, and scale much faster using AI. So what I did today is I asked ChatGPT, please generate a prompt that I can pass into ElevenLabs so that it will create a dental assistant that will answer questions and make appointments on demand. So this is what it generated, and I tweaked it a little bit, but it took me just a few minutes to do thanks to Gen AI. So that was very easy. So I've described the whole tone, what you're supposed to do, how to wrap up, and some additional notes. I also asked ChatGPT to generate some random knowledge base about Bob Dental Care, which is this random name that I picked, and it's creating some opening hours and FAQs and a bunch of questions that I've added in there. This is all fake, but this will be useful as context that we pass into ElevenLabs to answer the questions. Now we're going to go into conversational AI, which is something that was released recently. In there, we're going to be creating an agent. I'll start from blank. So this is the new agent interface in here. I will select English as the main language. I will also test the French language here. The first message I will paste in, and then I will paste in my entire prompt. And then if we scroll, you can decide which model you want to use. It currently defaults to Gemini 2. It says 1.5 is the fastest, so I'm just going to stick to that. The temperature allows you to control how much you want to deviate from the script. Typically for a voice AI, you don't want to go too far from the script. It's right in the middle in here. If you want it to be more creative, you're going to push it to the right. If you want to be like, no, just stick to your script, that you're going to want to push it more to zero. I found the middle to be perfect for here. The limit token usage, we don't really need that for right now. The knowledge base is what I was talking about before. I generated this Google Doc that has all the information about anything about Bob Dental. So I'm going to pass in that file. There are ways to also integrate with tools. This is you want to integrate with an actual third-party software like a calendar, a CRM, something like that. So you can add those tools in here. I will get to that later on in the video. I'm going to save all my changes so we don't lose anything. And then I'm going to go into the voice tab. So it defaults to Eric for the voice that they offer here. I found Mark to be way more natural. It doesn't sound fake. So I really like that one. So that's what I've done. All the rest I'm leaving empty. The one thing that I did find with Mark is he's a little slow to speak and to respond. So right now the value is at 1. I'm going to push it to 1.10. So I'm going to save that. Then the rest, everything's going to be remaining as default. So a very interesting part is the widget that comes with ElevenLabs. You see that little widget at the bottom right of the screen? That's something that you could add to your website today. And so that allows you to actually make a call directly from the browser. And you can even select your language if you've selected multiple languages. And this is the only thing that you need to do. You just need to embed your code in here and you're all set and all good to go. And you can customize the appearance. So it's really good for the website as a way to get the customer service call feature really out of the box. So that is it for the configuration. As you can see, it was very straightforward. I've maybe spent a few minutes on the prompt, but that is it. Everything else is going to come out of the box. So let's test it out. So because I've selected English and French, I'm seeing those two options here. As of right now, ElevenLabs is not really doing a good job as switching in the middle of the conversation. But if you are able to select one from the beginning, it will be able to have the full conversation with you. So I'm going to start with the easy one, English. We can try the French one later on.
Hi, this is Bob Dental Care. How can I help you today?
Hi, I was wondering if you're open for Memorial Day.
Hi there. We are closed on Memorial Day in 2025. Is there anything else I can help you with today?
Yeah, do you take my insurance? It's United Healthcare.
We accept most major dental insurance plans, including United Healthcare. Is there anything else I can help you with?
Yeah, I would like to make an appointment. My teeth are really hurting.
I'm sorry to hear that you're in pain. Let's prioritize your appointment immediately so we can help you as soon as possible. Before we proceed, may I ask if you are an existing patient with us?
Yes, I am.
I'll check our earliest availability to get you in right away. Let me see what we have for you. We have an opening tomorrow at 10:30 a.m. Would that work for you?
Do you have anything at 11:30 instead?
Let me check. Unfortunately, we're fully booked at 11:30 a.m. tomorrow. How about 1:30 p.m.?
1:30 works. Thank you so much.
You're very welcome. Your appointment is now confirmed for tomorrow at 1:30 p.m. Thank you for choosing Bob Dental Care.
So that was very easy. That was super smooth. Just a few minutes of setup, and here we are with a full agent in English that worked really well and that answered all my questions. It didn't ask for my name. That's part of the test. Even the calendar is not plugged in yet, so it's just making updates at this point. Let's try the French one.
Bonjour, ici Bob Dental Care. Comment puis-je vous aider aujourd'hui?
Est-ce que je pourrais avoir un rendez-vous, s'il vous plaît?
Bien sûr, je peux vous programmer pour le prochain créneau disponible.
So there we go. We kind of had a full conversation in French. There's nowhere in the world where you can do that, be able to have that conversation at 4 a.m. on a Sunday. Only AI will give you the ability to have an appointment made at that time in your language. So there's a tremendous opportunity with AI. It also has the full call history. So if you need to ever go back, or if you want to just keep a pulse on the AI and make sure it's doing a good job and QAing, you can listen to all those calls. You get the full transcription and what language. It also shows how many credits each call is using. That's just if you want to monitor the usage. I'm currently on the free plan, and the free plan gives you 10,000 credits. You can go a pretty long way. So the free one includes 15 minutes of conversational AI. The creator, this is $20 a month for 250 minutes. That is just incredible. And that was really cool. I just built that in a few minutes. It does not integrate currently with the calendar, and that's what I'm about to show you and how to integrate with cal.com. But it can really integrate with anything, because as you saw before, it integrates using what's called webhooks. So you really can plug and play with any other software that has any APIs available, which is most tools at this point. So I'm about to show you that in a second. All right, so I've updated everything so that it actually connects to cal.com now. So we're going to look at what was changed. Not a lot of touch points, actually. The most important thing to change in the prompt is that you're going to need to update the scheduling logic. You need to explain that get availability is going to be used as a tool to check the availability, as the name suggests. It's going to be all at 1 hour appointments. And then when everyone agrees with the date and time, then you're going to use the book appointment tool. So this is all I needed to add in here. This is really just the main logic here. The next thing that I changed is the LLM. Per the documentation, and there was also a pop-up when I added the tools, it actually said that they don't recommend Gemini anymore. So I'd recommend it to change to 4.0 Mini or to Sonnet. I found 4.0 Mini to be a bit better at this time. Temperature remained the same, knowledge base remained the same. Here are the two main things that I've changed. There's two webhooks that I've set up. The first one is get availability. As I've mentioned before, this is how it connects to cal.com. This is the name, so that's important that it needs to match. There's a small description. It uses LLM to actually try to build that function. So in here, you're going to see V2 slots. You're going to need to pass a few headers, including the API version. In here, all I'm doing is I'm looking at the official documentation for that specific endpoint, find out when an event type ready to be booked. So it's saying do a get on V2 slots. Here's the API version. It must be the specific version. So I've passed in what they recommended me. And then in the authorization, what you're going to want to create is, and you see it behind, there's a workspace secret that you need to create. So the really one important thing from authorization is that it needs to start with bearer space. If not, this is not going to work. If you get a 403, most likely that is the reason. So you're going to need to create that secret, and then you reference that secret in here. Content type application JSON, that's optional. So another parameter that they recommend is to put a start and an end. All I did for the description is copying whatever is in the API documentation, so whatever they recommend. So this is using UTC and a specific ISO date string. This is all from the documentation. The event type ID is actually how you connect to cal.com. So make sure that when you create your account, you're gonna go into your event. I created a 1 hour meeting, and as you see, there is an ID being generated here on the URL. This is the event ID that you're looking for. So make sure to grab that. And then you can pass it as a LLM prompt, as it should always be that value. So important, because this is a get availability method, get. The parameters are passed as query parameters. Now I'm going to show you the book appointment, which is the second step of we're actually like placing the appointment when the person agrees. This one is a post. So we're not adding the same query parameter, we're adding them as body parameter. So that's an important key. So in here, this is very similar. I just follow the documentation for bookings. I'm just looking at whatever they're saying here on the API version. This is August 13th. So this is what I added. This is August 13th. Authorization is going to be the same API key. Content type is the same, just so they know we're passing JSON. Then in the body parameter, again, this is not the query because this is a post. So we're going into body parameters. We're passing in a description. Then there's a start. So this is the start of the 1 hour appointment. So this is what needs to be passed in. And then there is the attendee, which it in itself is an object because it needs a few things inside, including what time zone the person is in, what their email is. So I've put a placeholder value. If you had a CRM or something like that, you already know the person's email from their phone number. So you can do some things in there. For now, if you don't want to send an email to the customer, you could do that. If not, you could ask the person to spell it out during the call. But it's a bit cumbersome. So the next one is the name that's going to be prompted over the call. And the event ID, very last. And that's the same event ID as before. And then there's one tiny thing that I added into analysis. In order to have proper call history with a success, failure, or unknown, it's just adding some sort of status to know which call went well and which one did not. So what you can define is a list of statuses that you want to pass in. And for each of those statuses, what they mean, right? So success means all the questions were answered and they were able to book a meeting successfully if they requested it. This same for failure or unknown, if something get disconnected. And that is all I changed in the agent. So let's give it a try with those changes. Let's see what happens.
Your appointment is now confirmed for tomorrow, February 28th at 9 p.m. Thank you for providing your name, Remi Taffin.
All right, so we can stop here. That was a really awesome call. If I go to the call history now, it will actually show the whole transcript, and it will also show all the parameters that were passed in. So when we try to get availability, it showed the date into the future with the event type ID, and then the results. And then you can see the book appointment. It seems it misspelled my name, but that's fine. It was a success, and it generated the event. And then if I go to cal.com, let's see. There you go. It created the appointment for me in cal.com. And just like that, in under 15 minutes, you've built a fully automated AI receptionist that books appointments 24/7. Imagine how much time and money that could save for your business. If you have any questions, drop them below. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe for more AI automation tips. I'll be sharing more ways to use AI to grow your business faster and work less. And if you're serious about automating your business, check out my other videos on AI automation. I'll see you in the next one.